Talks.
Hello, and welcome to this online tech talk. Our topic today is migrating your data to Amazon RDS for Oracle using Oracle Transportable Tablespaces. My name is Nathan Fusi, and I'm a Principal Product Manager with RDS for Oracle. We'll start with a brief overview of RDS for Oracle. Next, we'll discuss Amazon Elastic File System, or Amazon EFS, integration with RDS for Oracle. We'll review the various paths to migrate your Oracle data to RDS for Oracle, including leveraging EFS integration. With that context, we'll discuss migrating data leveraging Oracle Recovery Manager, or RMAN, incrementally updated backups, and the cross-platform capabilities of Oracle Transportable Tablespaces. I'll call out some best practices for performing your migration, and then I'll show a demo of migrating data to RDS for Oracle using Transportable Tablespaces and EFS. We have moderators available to take your questions, so please ask questions at any time. And we'll share a survey code toward the end of the presentation, and we really hope you'll take a moment to let us know if this content is useful. For those who are not as familiar with Amazon RDS, RDS for Oracle is a managed database service with automation, monitoring, and advanced capabilities built in, including automated backup and recovery, high availability, compute and storage scaling, OS and database patching, and more. By automating these aspects of database administration, you can achieve greater efficiency for your DBA staff, improved application uptime and performance, and enable advanced HA and DR functionality that can be much more costly to implement if you manage yourself. This frees you up to focus on high-skill, high-value activities like schema and application design and tuning. The integration between RDS for Oracle and Amazon EFS allows you to store and access files on EFS from your RDS instance via an Oracle database directory that maps to the EFS file system. This enables access to serverless storage on a pay-as-you-go basis without growing your RDS for Oracle instance storage. It allows you to share data between multiple database instances as well as between application servers, reducing manual data transfers and costs to store multiple copies of the data. When it comes to migrating data into RDS for Oracle, your options have been limited to logical migration. SQL extracts or copying data over database links, log mining, and other tools for change data capture. You can use bulk data movement with Oracle Data Pump or the export utility, creating dump files on the local system, uploading those to S3, downloading to your instance, and importing into the database. With EFS integration, you can create your dump files directly on EFS from your source database and then import them directly into your RDS for Oracle instance. This eliminates multiple steps compared to S3 integration, reducing migration effort. It also reduces serialized file movement, saving time and giving you access to your data faster. It also means the dump files are stored in only one place, reducing storage costs. Best of all, the dump files are never stored on the RDS instance, eliminating storage expansion for a temporary need. With Oracle Transportable Tablespaces, you can now perform a physical migration from your source Oracle database. This includes cross-platform migrations and even from Unix OSs like Solaris and AIX that require Endian conversion, which are handled seamlessly by this feature. Because the feature uses Oracle RMAN, you can leverage online backups while the source tablespaces are in read-write mode. RMAN also supports incrementally updated backups, saving load on the source database and space consumed for the backups, as well as allowing you to plan the cutover to suit your business needs. Incrementally updated backups reduce the time required for the application cutover process, as you only need to apply the latest incremental backup in the last phase of the migration. Let's walk through a migration from an on-premises source to RDS for Oracle, putting it all together. EFS can be mounted by an on-premises server over a VPN connection or AWS Direct Connect. Using RMAN, create a full backup of the source tablespaces directly on the EFS file system. Using the RDS APIs, restore the tablespaces onto the target instance. Now you can take repeated incremental backups on the source and convert and apply those updates to the data files on the target instance. you can repeat this process until you're ready to complete the migration. At that point, you'll place the source tablespaces in read-only mode and take one more incremental backup and apply it. You'll also export metadata to EFS for the tablespaces via Oracle Data Pump. Import the data on the target to complete the transport. Run an integrity check on the tablespaces, and then place the tablespaces in read-write mode on the target. At this point, your migration is complete and your applications may be cut over. Transportable tablespaces are great for migrating large objects or LOB data, which can be difficult for log mining or change data capture tools to replicate with good performance. Still, you can combine transportable tablespaces with other migration methods. You can parallelize your migration by employing multiple methods that are each best suited to the data. Lastly, always take a manual DB snapshot of your instance prior to running the tablespace import step. If you encounter any issues on import, you can restore the snapshot, correct the issue, and retry the import without having to restore the backups again. Now let's move on to the demo. For this demo purpose, we've already created an EFS mount, so let's look at the configuration of XTTS-EFS. Here's the EFS ID. And now let's look at our RDS test instance. We'll find that in our list of instances. It's called ORCL-XTTS. Looking at the configuration tab, we see the option group of XTTS demo EFS integration. And we note that it's in sync or active for the instance. Now, looking at that option group, we can scroll down and see that our RDS instance is associated, ORCL-XTTS, and we look and verify that we have the EFS integration option enabled for the option group, and there's that same EFS file system ID. Now we connect to our RDS target instance, and we're first going to check whether there's any failed XTTS effort to clean up. There isn't, so we can proceed. We check our time zone file version and character sets, and now we create a database directory that points to the EFS mount, and we can see that there are no files there. On our source database, we confirm that our time zone version is less than or equal to the target for data pump purposes, and it is. And we also confirm that our character set is a match or a subset of the target character set. This is required for data pump to work. We identify our two tablespaces to transport, sales order entry and sales history. Both are online, and we run a transport check on these two tablespaces and confirm that they're self-contained. There are no violations that will prevent us from transporting them. We confirm that our EFS file system is mounted and contains no files yet. Zero files, as expected. So we're going to change directory to where we have downloaded and extracted the zip file from Oracle's support site that contains the XTTS driver script. And we'll edit the xtt.properties file to set our source platform ID. Now, that platform ID is important in cases where we transport across platforms, like from Unix to Linux, which is what RDS for Oracle runs on. And we specify the tablespaces to transport, as well as the location where backups should be written as our EFS mount. Now, we're going to kick off the backup script to generate a level zero or full backup of the SOE and SH tablespaces. The script runs, and now we can see our backup pieces in the EFS directory. Look at the contents of the restore.txt file or res.txt and see that the details of the tablespace and data file backup pieces are there. Now we change the permissions on the backups to make it so that RDS can access those backups. Connecting to RDS, we can now see the files in our data pump directory by listing the contents. We try importing the tablespaces, but Oracle complains that our restore.txt file doesn't exist. So back on the source system, we copy that res.txt file from the temporary directory to the EFS mount. And now back on the target instance, trying again, our import call succeeds, returning a task ID. And we can view the contents of that task log, where we see from the task output that the latest import attempt was indeed successful. Now we go back to our source database and capture an incremental backup. We set our environment variables and execute the backup driver script again. It generates two more backup pieces on the EFS mount, and we copy the res.txt file over to EFS as well, and we open up permissions on all three files for RDS to read them. Shifting back to the RDS instance, we repeat the steps to import the tablespaces on our target database. Using the same steps as before, we connect to the instance and view our data pump directory files. We run the import stored procedure and verify successful completion. On our source database, we'll now generate our last incremental backup. First, we'll set our tablespaces to read-only mode, and then we'll run the same incremental backup script as on previous runs. We see that it generates two more backup pieces for the tablespaces being transported. And we look at the contents of the res.txt file. We'll set the permissions on the backup pieces and res.txt one more time. This time, we'll also use Oracle Data Pump to export the metadata for the tablespaces to the EFS mount. Now we have all of the necessary files on EFS. Shifting to the target instance, we list the directory contents. And we're going to kick off one final import. We'll grab that task ID from the stored procedure call and view the output of the task. And note that line, the task finished successfully. Now, onto the console, we want to take a manual DB snapshot prior to attempting to import the metadata. This is important, as I mentioned, in case we hit any correctable error during the metadata import. It'll save us time in simply restoring our snapshot and retrying rather than importing the data all over again. So with that snapshot complete, we go back to our source database. We check and we see we have two schemas with data in our chosen tablespaces to create on our target database, SOE and SH, before importing the metadata. So we'll shift over to our target and we'll create these schemas and then run the metadata import. Looking at the output, we can see that the import was successful. Now we want to validate the transport process using RMAN physical and logical validation. We'll validate each of the transported tablespaces, first SOE, then SH, and the validation completes, and now we can review the output, noting that the two data files have been validated and no blocks failed. Now we alter the two tablespaces to read-write mode, and we can check and see several gigabytes of segments as well as dozens of segments across the two tablespaces, and we verify the tablespaces are online. and that completes the transport and the demo. Here are some useful resources as you attempt to migrate using Transportable Tablespaces for RDS for Oracle. And with that, we'll say thank you for joining us in this online tech talk today. We hope you found the content useful and you'll leave us some feedback. Thank you.